Cuan Law, 105-foot sailing trimaran. This is our main deck out here on the aft deck. This is where everything happens. So dive briefings, meals, and all that kind of stuff. When set up for dinner, the table's set up like this, and we can seat 24 people comfortably at table. In the center, we do normally post a schedule for the day's events, whatever's going on that day. When not in use, there's plenty of space on the deck as everything collapses down for people to move around or lounge or do everything they'd like. When we're diving, we've got people getting geared up here. You can fit two people at a time getting into gear, and it goes quite quickly once people get the hang of how it works here for us. Up on the dive deck is where we store all the dive gear and fill tanks. This is our fill station here. So we can fill 20 air tanks at once, but we stock more tanks on board than that. We can also fill 10 nitrox tanks stowed over here. There's plenty of room to hang wetsuits and dive gear around this space. This is also where you're gonna find the two other kayaks. And this is where we lift and lower both of our tenders from as well. Down here is access to the aft cabin.
Come this way.
This is a lounge area, but it's also where we do quite a lot of storage. Drinks are stored down here, as well as crew uniforms and quite a lot of things are stored down here. All right, so this is the bow and pulpit of Cuan Law, the center hull. Here we've got access to the windlass and access to the crew companionway. This is how we'll get the crew get in and out of their quarters here from the bow. And then on this side, we've got access to another crew cabin in the port pontoon, which is mirrored on the starboard side as well. The same over there. We've got one kayak here, which is also mirrored on the other side. So there's two single kayaks. We've also got two more kayaks in the back, which we'll show later. Up on the main deck, we've got Rika lounging over here. And we've also got two Kobe cats, one on each side. They take a little bit of time to launch, but they're not too difficult. We currently store two paddle boards here, one on each side again as well. And most of the work is done by the crew on board. So while we do have an electric winch on the capstan, a lot of work gets done by hand on the coffee grinders here in the center. We've got hammocks for lounging, and typically the boat's rigged with two roller furler jibs forward and two hanked on staysails, which are not on the boat currently, and then a trysail, which runs up the back side of the foremast and the mainsail here. So the cockpit itself is pretty basic. There's not a lot to it. We've got the steering wheel, gauges and controls for the two main engines, as well as controls for the roller furlers. We've got the electric chart plotter, which has got the radar and everything plotted in here. It's quite a new unit. It's just been put in. That's about it for here. In through here is access to the saloon. In the saloon, we've got charts where we actually mark our track during the course of the week. Artwork by a local artist, and there's plenty of room to relax in here. There are fridges and freezers to store drinks that are cool, and a full bar area where there's always fresh water and cocktails or anything that you'd like can be made back here. As you can see, it's quite a large space, plenty of room for seating for a full boat, and it's a good place to watch movies in the evening as well. This is one of our guest cabins here. They're all pretty much the same. There's nothing crazy. This bed can either be made up as a double bed for two to sleep together, or it can be broken up into two beds for people to sleep apart. There's storage and AC for each unit individually. Each unit also has a hatch on the side and above, and they've got each a private head, toilet, shower, and another hatch. Down here's access to the galley. In the galley itself, we've got two big deep fridges with plenty of space. We've got the ovens, stovetop, and the broiler. We've got plenty of storage, dishwasher and galley sink. And then there's more storage leading forward. But it gets a bit tight back there. Crew quarters are up here. As we head back, we've got wine storage, more dry stores for food. And then we've got two big freezers that also are quite deep. In here, we've got our washer dryer set up. And then storage for laundry. From here, I'm gonna pass everything off to Cam, our engineer. He's gonna show you all the mechanical workings of the boat.
Can you video?
All right, this is what we call the pump room, because it has all the pumps in it. The salt water pump, fresh water pump, and this is the main cooling pump. This is a hot water cylinder, you might find in a house, exactly the same, it's really thick. This is the refrigeration unit, which does the fridge, freezer, and the bar fridge upstairs. Over this side, we have our two commercial grade air conditioning units. You just have one running at a time. That ice machine. All right, so this is the workshop area. In this room, we have a lot more. This is our water baking station. Low pressure pump, filters, high pressure pump, reverse osmosis membrane, and down to the distribution board. Down here we have the main bilge pump, which is actually powered by air, so we can pump any bilge in the boat from here, including the black tanks and the grey water tanks. Here we have a central vacuum cleaning system which services the whole boat. And further around here we have our air banks for filling the dive cylinders in a hurry. These are up to 4,000 psi, whereas the tanks are only at 3,000, so we can drop these down to fill the tanks. Around here we have the power distribution panel, so we can send electricity from any generator to any part of the boat from here. These are military grade switches out of a tank, I'm told. Back here in all the shelving we have all the spare parts for the boat. We have to carry everything on board, all labelled and sorted. This is a brand new tool chest. Everything's quite well organised. We try to keep a very tidy ship. The rest of the tools and parts can be found on this side. It's in different drawers, it's all well organised. Alright, now we're on the engine room. Very hot and very loud. The port side of the engine, we have port main engine, 33 kilowatt generator, this is the shop air compressor, and this is the aft battery pack. Here is our big 65 kilowatt generator. Here and here we have our two dive compressors, this is nitrox, and this is air. Coming over to the starboard side, starboard 33. Nitrox membrane.